Okay, sorry. So here we will going to start about the string today, Java string. Am I audible, right?
Yes, sir.
So we're going to start about the Java string. So string is what a string is, a data type. And a string is a group of a character. Like when you want to save a group of a character, then you use a string, right? Suppose, what do you mean by character? Character is like A, B, C, a single character, you say it, right? But like suppose if you want to save your name like Akshara, Snigdha, how you are going to save it? You need to use then string data type, right? In that string data type, you will going to save within a double quote. Like suppose, Akshara and Snigdha, like this, right? So like this, you need to save it, right? So this is the difference between these two. Like a character is a single character that you want to save in this variable C. But suppose if you want to save a group of character, here, how many character there? Can you count it? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You need to count space also. Okay, so 8, 9, 10, then 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, right? So in this way, you can save it, right? Means you can save as much as a group of a character. So here, there is a single character, right? This one is a single character A. And here a group of character, right? Here we are talking about a group of character, like your name. And what the thing that we need to keep in mind that here, when you declare any character array, you will use a single quote, okay? So this point you need to remember everything, every time, that the character data type, where whatever value you save there, in this character variable, it will be saved within a single quote. So character is represented by single quote. Character data single quotes, you can say it, or single inverted comma, both are same. Okay, like this. Okay, sorry. Like this. And when you want to save a group of character, it will be saved within this double quotes. So this thing is an identification that if anyone give you, then how you will going to identify which is a string and which is a character. And obviously when you see the group of character, that will be the double quotes, right? That is a string. Okay, so this is the introduction part of this. Now, how you're going to perform an operation, okay? Like, let me create one string data type and let's do one program today. Okay, so I'm just creating the class. How we create a class in Eclipse? Go to the new class, click on the class name, string. Always take the first letter as a capital, and then you can give any name. Okay, once you get this structure, inside this you need to type it. Now I will going to type Now, how you print in a Java? Can you tell me what instruction you write it to print?
Out.println.
Correct. And always remember, like, suppose if you get any error in this Eclipse, just hover your cursor over it, so it will suggest you what mistake you are doing. So from that, you can get an idea also. Now here I will going to print my line A. Variable A. Similarly, I will print it for other two variable also. How we're going to access it. This is the program to access the element, to print the variable value. So B is your string and C is another string type. And how we're going to run it? In the last class, I have told you, right? How you run it in this Eclipse. Snigdha, you might know, right? How to run the program in the Eclipse? So we usually click here. We go on this and run as Java application. Okay, so we click on this Java application.
Yes.
And then it will suggest you, like, suppose if any error exists. But you can proceed it. Let's see whether there is error giving or what. So see, it is not given any error and it is printed. See, this is a character type. That's why you have given it. Let me try with another value. See, it is giving error. Why it is giving error? Because you can't save a group of character inside the character data type. Why? Because it is of how much data it holds, a single character it can save. Right? Character can hold a single character, but string can hold a group of character. That's why when you print it, it has printed. And when, if you want to print every time on the next line, which function you use, println. println will print in the next line the content. Okay, so this is your first variable value. This is your second variable value and third variable value. How did you find it out? What? And okay, if you want to find it out the len, okay, try it. Okay, 1 minute, let me check it. See, this len function will work with the string data. So when you run this, what it will give? This len function will give you what? When you run this len function with this variable, what value it will give? What is used for this len function? Len
would it give 6?
No. Why it will give 6?
Because it would be Snigdha would be 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Len function usually says the number of character in the string. Okay, first let me run this and then we can see it out. It is showing you 7. Why it is showing you 7? 6 is not the answer. The reason is len function will give you the length of the string, the number of character present in your name. How many number of character present in your name? 7, right? So the len function will give you the length of an element, or you can say the length of, or the number of character. Always remember this thing, length of the string will give you number of character present in the string variable. Okay, so that is the reason it's showing the 7. Okay, let me change this Snigdha to Sni. Suppose we all call you with the Sni name, okay, in your home, and to Akshara we call Aksh. Okay, so now how much, just see the changes, then you will come to know like what this len function they do. Okay, you can run this from this arrow button also, this green arrow button, click here, so it will run your program. So see, 4 and 3 is coming. Why 4? Because it is having 4 character.
But sir, won't it count 0 as 1, 2? Won't it be like 3?
No. That is in the case of array.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that you said, you are saying correct, but that you are saying 0, 1, 2, 3, that is in the place of array. Means when we work with array, at that time index start from 0 and it give you the length. Yes, but this length function will give you the length of the your name. Okay, just like Sni we call you, so Sni is having 3 character, that's why showing 3, and this is showing you 4 character. Similarly, when you if you want to see what else functions are available with the string, how you can do this, just write the variable name, put the dot there, and see, you can find it out, caret, code point, there are different functions are available. You can use any of this function. Okay, suppose I want to find out char index of this A, means I want to check it. Okay, let me write it down, the whole name. Okay, I want to find out which what is the character at index 0. Okay, suppose index we found. Okay, index will be here also, we use it. But the length function is not for the finding out the like index. Length function will give you the number of character present in the name. But suppose if you want to find out the element present at a particular index, so how you are going to do that? Let's check it with the 0 and print it. So C is what here? The variable name, your Snigdha. So let's see what it is giving, okay? So see, it is showing you S. Why it is showing S? Because this Snigdha is having S at a index 0. Okay.
Yes, sir. So
let me explain you how it works. Suppose you have a index like this, and let's take an example. Anything like suppose let me, okay, for example, I am saving in this string apple. Okay, this is not the array, it's just the string we have used it. So string is a group of a character, so each element will be referred by the index, means each element you can identify with the help of index. Okay, so here this will be present at index 0, this is at 1, this is at 2, this is at 3, and this is at 4. Okay, so suppose if you want to find it out the element which is present at index 0, so it will give you this one. Similarly, at 1 this, 2 this, 3 this, 4 this. That is the reason when you save this Snigdha in this C variable, so internally means in the memory or a compiler. What do you mean by this compiler, memory, everything? See, we write a code, okay? So this code should be saved somewhere, right? In order to run the bioprocessor or your system, we need to save it somewhere. Why? That's the reason we use RAM, hard disk, right? Are you getting? Is it clear?
Yes, sir. Yes.
So here, these programs are saving your RAM. Okay. So in that memory, you need something to save the data. So internally, they save like this. This is called a cell. Okay. Each block, they are called as a cell. And they are having an index similar to the array. The only difference is that the difference is like you can save inside this double quote, you can save a number also. Okay, number in the sense like if I declare here one, even then it will work. Means whatever you write inside double quote will be act as a string. Okay, let me check, show you. Instead of this, I'm writing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, and let me run this. So it is giving one at an index zero, right? So always remember, whatever you declare within this double quote will be act as a string. Okay. Similar thing, this 1, 2, 3 will be saved here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the index always start from zero. Okay. How this 1, 2, 3 will be saved? One, okay. Two. Now it might be a question coming in your mind. It is of number. Why we are calling as a string? So, as I said, you whenever you declare within a double quote, your programming language considered it, means your Java compiler considered it as a string. And what will be the index? Index start from zero. So if I ask you what is the index of the last element, then it will be length minus one. Okay, length means what? Length will tell you number of element in your string, right? So here, how many number of element? Six. What will be the last index? Last index will be your length minus one. This is a general mathematics, is very easy. What will be the length? Length will be your number of element, and when you subtract minus one from it, you will get the last index of the string, or even in array also it works like that. So that's why when you print it, it will give you character at. This caret function, it means that character at. Okay, you note down here, caret actually means character present at index whatever you pass it. So if I pass zero, so it will give me the character present at an index zero. If you pass one, it will give you that. So there are different function that is possible, and it only possible with the string variable. If you try with a, it will give error, right? You can see it is showing with the red sign. Why? Because a is of character type. So this all function is valid with the string data. Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Do you want to try on your system? Anyone? Apsara, you, anyone, do you want to try it?
Understood, sir. Should we?
Okay. What about Akshara?
Understood, sir.
Okay. So do you want to try it, Akshara, on your system, or is it fine? Will you able to do it, this program, if in the exam they ask you write a program on this array? Will you able to write it and use this function? Will you remember it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what this caret function they do? What this character at function they do? Can you answer? Just see this. Try to understand like what actually they are doing. read this comment, read this instruction, read this explanation that I have written. Answer me, like, are you able to understand?
It returns the character at the specified index in a string.
Yeah, correct. Okay. So this value here you are passing is index. Okay, this 1, 2, 3 is what? Your index. Similarly, you can perform some other operation also. Let's see what else operation on the string we can do it. So suppose let's remove this. As you put the dot after the variable, it will suggest you to which you want to use it. So let's take compare. So this is C dot compare to B. B is a variable, and here I'm comparing whether my C and B are equal or what. So let's run this and see what output we are getting. Minus 16 it is showing. Why it is printing minus 16? So it means that it will, in case if it is equal, then it will give you 1, otherwise 0. Okay, means if any of the elements matches. But here minus 16 tell you that it is not at all matching. You can read it from here also. Let me rub this and then I can explain you. So here, when you put the cursor over here, okay, you can see it. It tells you what they do. Comparison is based on the Unicode value of each character in the string. Character sequence represented by string object compare. So they are comparing based on some Unicode value. Unicode is a value that is understood by system. There are actually different kind of representation. Just like Snigdha Akshara, you understand English, right? I am conversed, like I am explaining you in the English. So we all are conversated in English, right? But system, how the system will understand? They will have some coding, Unicode languages like ASCII representation I explained you. Similarly, there is one more Unicode values are there. This Unicode values for each character, there is some Unicode value. Okay, what is that? Let me show you. There is some Unicode values are there, like this is some value that we don't remember it, but your system, they understand it. Okay, let me show you some more Unicode value Java one. Like this, you can see on my screen, right? There is some Unicode values are there, like this 30 is used for 0 or 31 is for 1. So there are some representation, means whatever key that are present on your keyboard, they're having some internal representation that is called Unicode value that is understood by your system. We just need to press 0, 1, 2, 3 ABCD. Your system will convert it automatically on this Unicode. So what is a Unicode? What do you mean by Unicode? Unicode is a encoding language that understand by your system.
Unicode will be zeros and ones.
Correct. So just note down here one more line. I am going to share this code so you can have a look on it after the class and note down this line also. Unicode is a unique value for every character present on the keyboard. That directly understand by your system, okay? And what example you will give it, just like I have given you example, like we are discussing in the language English, right? So English is our code, you can say it, that make you understand. If I'm saying you a word understand, you know the meaning, Akshara know the meaning, I know the meaning. So it is a kind of encoding, a unicode language between us. But what about system? System don't understand those English language, because if people, they are using this system in Australia, Germany, and in the whole world. So they all have a different language. So system, they need something to understand. So this Unicode representation is a unique value for every key on the keyboard, so that when we press it, your system can understand, just like ASCII value. Okay, so that's why when you are comparing these two, they are comparing based on the Unicode. Means what is the Unicode value of A and V and 1? Is this Unicode value of A and 1 are matching? Is this Unicode value of K and 2 are matching? So in the base of Unicode, so this works on the base of Unicode. So let's see some more example on this. What are the different kind of predefined functions are available in the string? Okay, let's try with the B this time. Let's try with the Akshara name. Just type the variable B and press dot. Then see what are the functions. So you can see if any of the function not available, you can put a cursor and you can find it out the detail about it. What actually is stand for, why we use it. So just put me one, let's try some other function. Okay, this trig function, what they will do, it will remove the space. If any space is present in the name, it will remove it, this trig function. So they will try to remove it, the trailing edge, trailing means at the backside edge, backside space, and at the starting of the space. So let me run this and check whether it is able to do it here or not. So just run this first. So see this, it has removed it, right? And when you run it again, this values got changed, right? You can check it, because I have added here space. So that space also have a Unicode value that is compared with this 1 and 2. That's why this value got changed. So note down, this trip function is used to remove space at the starting and the trailing edge. If you put the cursor here, it will tell you leading and trailing white space. Leading means at the start, trailing means at the end. So once you put the cursor over it, you can get it. So strip function, note down this somewhere in your notebook, that strip function is used to remove leading and trailing space in the string. Okay, so we have seen different kind of function, length function, what they do it. So length function is used to find number of character present in the string. And this will ask in the exam length of character at compare to this all function. They will ask you either in the brief question or they will give you the program. Then you can, with the help of this function, you can find it out easily. Okay, so let's try if some more example. Let's see, there is some more example is there, what we can use it. Let me run this and see. So now here, okay, let me remove the space. What is doing this two char array, what they are doing, they are converting your string into the array. To which array? Character array. When you use this function two char array, they will convert your string data into the character array. So what function you will going to use it to convert that two char array? Let me run this. So see here, it is printing in that way. So note down here. Two char array. Function is used for what? It is used to convert your string variable into the character array. String variable, what is a variable name here? B1. Okay, let's try with C1. Okay, let's change the name here to Snigdha. So here you can see it convert this C is what your variable name, and it is converting this C variable, which is holding this value Snigdha, to the character array. So two character function is used to convert string variable to character array. Okay, so let's see any other function or possible. So let's see some more function here. Just remove this and type dot and just check it, which function. There are different functions are available here. I'm telling you the selected one so that you can try it. Yeah, two lowercase. Okay, so you can use this two lowercase function to convert it into the lowercase. Suppose let me take it. And run it first and let's see what output we are getting. So you see here, this is the output of this one. Okay, this is for actually your converting an array, but this is the output for your this lowercase. So it is doing what? It is converting string variable C into lowercase, means small letter. That's why it is showing it. So uppercase is also possible. You can try it with an uppercase. So you can try with your uppercase. Okay, so in this lecture, as I have shown you, like how you can apply, how you can play with this string data. Okay, how you can find out the length, how you can find out the character present at index, any index, how you can compare it, how you can strip it. And this comment will give you an idea. Okay, I will share this whole code with you in the chat I will send you. Read this comment. This comment is a complete explanation of that particular function, and run the whole code on your system, on your Eclipse. Do it exactly same way. Click on this file, click on the new, click on this class. So when you click on this class, give any name that you want to do it. For example, string demo2, add this public static void main. So when it will appear on your screen, by default it will come. Okay, and then click on the finish. So see, it has came, right? Now you can start writing the code here. It will come, class name, whatever you have set, it will come. This main method is also will come by default. You just need to write down the instruction here. Okay, is it clear? Is it clear to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay.